Hello and welcome to Q4 with BQ. We are joined by Rajiv Kumar Gupta, the Managing Director at GNFC, to take us through their fourth quarter numbers. Rajiv, first of all, thank you very much for speaking to Bloomberg Quint. Let me first start off with your top line. Your revenues adjusted for excise have grown by more than 40% on a year-on-year basis. Just wanted to understand where this growth is coming in from and what is the outlook for FY19?
You see, the growth has been all around. The growth has been in all segments, both in the chemical segment and also in the fertilizer segment to some extent. But as far as chemicals are concerned, the growth has not only been in TDI, but also in many other chemicals like formic acid, ethyl acetate, technical grade urea, and so on and so forth. So some of our plants have given the highest ever production, and some of the realizations in chemicals like aniline, formic acid, and technical grade urea have been highest ever. Having said that, the growth has also been substantial and noticeable in our TDI segment. TDI capacity utilizations have increased from 73% as we recorded last year to 93%. And our target for this year is to go beyond 100% as far as TDI business is concerned, and at the same time increase growth trend in other non-TDI segment as well.
So, sir, with such high capacity utilization levels and the strong demand outlook, do you have any capital expansion plans going forward?
Yes, very much. The company is a debt-free company as far as long-term debt is concerned. We started with a debt of 4,000 crores and 2,500 crores of non-productive and non-operational assets plus 600 crores of EPCG obligations. So in all, a liability of almost 7,000 crores 3 years back. Mm-hmm. And that resulted in a net loss of 452 crores. And from that level, we have recorded a profit of 790 crores. From a level of 4,000 crores of debt, we have become a completely long-term debt-free company as on 31st March this year. As far as working capital utilizations are concerned, from a level of 1,700 crores, we have reduced them to barely less than 250 crores, to be precise, 227 crores. Our medium-term and short-term target is to even reduce that working capital utilization to zero. Having said that, now the company has reached a stage where the top line has to increase by capex. And my board has yesterday authorized me to go ahead at least in two very strong areas, that is acetic acid and formic acid, wherein we are planning capacity expansion. At the same time, we are also planning to pump in some money, about 150 crores in our TDI business, to make it sustainable at 120% level. We also plan to expand partly in concentrated nitric acid and also in our ammonia production. So that way, the board has authorized me to undertake necessary action as far as the CAPEX program is concerned in certain key focus areas.
Okay. And sir, how do you plan to fund these CAPEX?
Well, partly they will be funded from our own revenue generation and partly from fresh debt that we can raise, because we have wiped out all our old debts.
Okay. And sir, also I've been looking at your margin trends over the past 5 to 6 quarters. And apart from a one-off in the fourth quarter of last year, are these 20 or 25% plus kind of margins sustainable going forward?
Well, we have done exceedingly well in certain chemicals like formic acid, ethyl acetate, and technical grade urea, and there is still a lot of scope to further improve the performance in many other chemicals, because we make almost 20-21 types of chemicals. In TDI, as I already said, from 93% level, our target for this year is about 110%. Even in fertilizer, the complex fertilizer, and even in urea, we had a little bit of technical problem in our ammonia plant, and we had to run that plant for a last couple of weeks on a low capacity. So that capacity utilization also will increase in this current year after we make some necessary adjustment and changes in the key equipments there. So capacity utilization both in fertilizer segment and in the chemical segment has further scope of improvement.
Okay, and coming on to the pricing, sir, if you can give us an understanding of what the current market price is for TDI and what was that same number, say, the last year. So if you can just give us an understanding of what the TDI price trend has been on a year-on-year basis.
See, I'll give you a perspective in this. when GNFC registered the first ever loss of 452 crores, our TDI plant in Dahej, which is the biggest plant and the only plant of India, was non-operational, non-functional, and almost a junk plant. And from that level, we started, and in 2015-16, we registered a profit of 226 crores. But I would like to caution you here that in that very year, the TDI prices went down by 26%. So GNFC's rise, or GNFC's comeback, or GNFC's better performance was not only attributed to TDI. TDI prices went down in that year, but the non-TDI segment performed 90% better. So we increased our performance level in aniline, in ethyl acetate, in formic acid, and in weak and concentrated nitric acid. And then gradually the TDI prices have also been moving forward. Now, as far as the current trend and near future trend of TDI prices is concerned, we see prices stabilizing around $4,000. Domestically, we have been selling at 3 lakh plus. So sometimes it comes to 290, sometimes it goes to 315. But domestically, the demand has been healthier. There has been a 20% increase in domestic demand. We have covered more than 65% of the domestic market, and we started almost with 32%. So that way, in TDI and in all other chemicals, for instance, in formic acid, we... India is consuming right now 34 to 36,000 tons of formic acid, of which 22,000 tons of formic acid is being produced by GNFC, and the rest is being imported. Okay. So we are planning to increase our formic acid production by making necessary adjustment in the existing plant to the tune of almost 6,000 to 8,000 tons. And we are also planning to acquire, if possible, the closed down plant of RCF. If that happens, we will be fulfilling the entire demand of the country in next few years. Similarly, in case of acetic acid, there has been a demand of almost a million tons, of which 160,000 tons is being produced, and that too is being produced by GNFC alone. Now, the rest all is being imported. So our board has decided that we should further expand in acetic acid area, and we have been... doing the necessary groundwork on that. So there is a lot of scope in key chemicals where imports are excessive and domestic production is falling short of demand.
Okay. And in fact, sir, my next question was on formic acid side. Any timeline that you can share with us as to when this acquisition will be completed?
These are things which are going on in full swing. Now, I cannot, you know, jump the gun. So you have to wait. But we are very, very decisive.
Okay. And so we are also seeing a lot of traction in the neem segment. So what are your plans in terms of new product additions and your top line targets, if you can share over the course of, say, next 2 to 3 years?
Neem vertical, we developed to fulfill Honorable Prime Minister's vision of 100% coating of neem urea, and it's been expanding. We set up a target of almost 50 crores turnover this financial year, which hopefully we have almost achieved. Now, neem we will take to another level in next 6 months' time, and we will widely expand our marketing and distribution network, and we have been adding one product almost every fortnight. So almost 20 products we have developed, and we are going to go in for massive marketing and massive expansion of this entire neem project. And capacities are also being ramped up. Almost a 10 ton per day capacity of neem soap plant is being planned. It's on the track. We have also launched Neem Night, the first mosquito repellent using neem, and we are going to increase the capacity for that as well. Neem face wash has been launched. Similarly, a host of neem products like neem lotion, neem moisturizing cream, neem face wash, all those kinds of things have been launched. So neem, we are aiming to take it to another level in next 6 to 8 months' time, and obviously the turnover is going to increase.
Okay, and but so if you can just share what your internal targets are, what the turnover could be for this segment.
Spoken many a times in public domain on this, that neem has a potential of 500 crores turnover in next 3 years.
Okay, so we'll leave it at that. Thank you so much, Rajiv, for speaking to us. Well, that was the management of GNFC. With that, it's a wrap. Thank you for watching.